Boris Effect Sapphire has all the building blocks you need to create a gorgeous cinematic look. I'm Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and in this short tutorial, we're going to see how we can put together a few little sapphire effects to create an instant filmic look. Now, we're starting in Adobe Premiere Pro, but pretty much everything that we look at is going to work the same way wherever Sapphire is supported. And if we look at our first clip here, it's pretty well balanced. It's a little bit low contrast, but you know, there's a lot of diffusion going on in the scene. So let's apply the only effect that we actually need to use, and that is the Sapphire Builder. And we can find that by searching in our effects for S_effect. And let's bring that over onto our clip and let's edit this effect. So here we are in Builder, and this is where we can easily put together all of the sapphire effects that we can see on the left-hand side down into the middle workspace and see what's happening in the viewer above. There are three things we really want to focus on here. We're going to look at color, grain, and vignette. And let's just use the search bar here to search for color. And I'm going to find the one that I want, which is ColorFuse Looks. So if you want to learn more about ColorFuse, we do have videos that are dedicated simply to ColorFuse. But if I load in a preset, we can have a little look here. But it's a way of using different creative LUTs to mix together to form completely unique colors as a way of finishing off our shot. Now, I'm looking for one that's quite flexible because I want to make this a sort of general purpose sort of effect. We can always change it, but you know, the idea is to make it more general purpose at the start. So I'm going to take one of the mixy ones, like M heavy film color, just load that in. And over on the right hand side in the parameters, we can easily, you know, mix these down, as you can see. So we do have a lot of flexibility still here. Okay, so moving past color, we're going to go on to grain. So if I go back into the search there, type in grain. From Sapphire 2023 onwards, we have this effect called UltraGrain. And this is a fast and flexible way of doing grain emulation. Again, I'll load in a preset here. You can see we've got a lot of different cameras available to us. You know, a lot of Sony, Reds. What I'm going for is maybe something a little bit more kind of generic, a little bit filmy. So maybe I'll just type in Kodak here. And we've got some of the sort of color film ones that we can see. Maybe we'll just take in 35mm, 400T, generic. I mean, it doesn't get much more generic than that. Excellent. All right. And then the final one is a vignette. So I'm going to type in vignette. Oh, look, lo and behold, I have a little vignette I can bring in here. And we've got, you know, lots of different things we can do with this, but we'll come and look at that in a little bit. Now I'm going to zoom in because I want to talk just very briefly about effect order, or the order of effects that we have down here. Because at the moment we have our source image going into the color fuse, going into ultra grain, going into vignette. So vignette is the final one. Yeah. This is the way that I often see people, you know, chain these things together. But is this the right way of doing it? Is it the most flexible way of doing it? Let's take a little look at something that Sapphire Vignette can do that not all the vignette effects can do. I'm going to take my opacity down so that it's not doing any of the color vignetting, but I'm going to take my blur amount up. And actually, I'm just going to zoom in a little bit here, and you can see that as soon as we put blur on at this point, because it's happening after the ultra grain, it's completely giving the game away. Like, realistic grain wouldn't work like that, because obviously grain is part of the film structure that comes at the end. It's part of the medium that we're shooting. So we want to move this around. We want ultra grain to be at the end. And now if we take a little look here, we have our vignette blurring up, but also being grained out afterwards. Down the bottom corner, I'm going to turn off preview selective node. So we're always going to see the result. So that means when I switch into my vignette here, we can much more easily see what's happening. If I turn my blur up a lot, you can see the grain still stays over the top of it, giving us that natural look that we want. I'm going to hit OK because I want to show you a little problem that we've got. So I hit OK, it brings us back into our host, and if we take a little look in the effects controls, we can see all of the controls down here. Now this is a lot to handle. This is, you know, maybe not quite as involved as putting them all on separately, but it's still pretty involved. It's still doing a lot more work than I want it to. So let's come back up and edit the effect. And what I can do is I can go through each of these effects in Builder and say which are the parameters that I want to be visible in the host or not. And not every host supports this, but all of the Adobe ones do, but your chosen host may vary a little bit. So with ColorFuse looks, we want all of the LUT strengths to be on and available. With the vignette, I'll turn everything off because really all I want is maybe the radius, the opacity and the blur amount. So let's take those three. And with the UltraGrain, again, I'll turn everything off. And the only ones I want to be available in the host is going to be grain amplitude, grain size, grain blur, and grain mono. So now I hit OK on that again, come back into our host. You can see we have a much more simplified and easier to manage type of effect. So we can come in, change up our LUT strength there, change up the blur amount in our vignette, and maybe touch in a little bit of darkening into it as well. And control how much grain we add in there. Maybe it was a little bit too much last time. Now I've been very sensible and I'm working on an 8K clip. Maybe I'll just do a little render and then we can play that back. And so we've got our stylized color, our vignette and our grain all in one. And I can happily save this effect as a preset. So save that there. I'll call this one Ben's Cine Look. Give it any characteristics I want, but I'll just but we'll leave that there, save that out. And now I can load that preset in directly through SFX. And it doesn't actually matter where I do that. So even if I go into something like Photoshop, if I have Sapphire available, I can find my Builder effect, Cine Look, load it up, and there it is, available to me directly within another application. And even change any of the looks up in ColorFuse. And there we go. And it really is as simple as that. And of course you can keep chaining things together. Maybe you want to add in a little bit of ultra glow before the grain. There's nothing to stop you mixing this together how you want it. I hope you found this trip into Sapphire's Builder useful and that it inspires you to do something yourself. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I will see you again soon. Bye for now. If you want to learn more about ColorFuse, UltraGrain or the Builder, then subscribe to this channel and also head over to the Boris Effects website, where you'll find hours of free training for Sapphire and all the other Boris Effects products at borisfx.com.